There's a mysterious phenomenon in our lineage that couldn't be solved for several decades, and it revolves around the mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell. You see, mitochondria are the only organelles other than the nucleus that contain genetic material. But while the DNA in the nucleus is a mix from both parents, the mitochondrial DNA is derived solely from the mother. This unique phenomenon is conserved in almost all organisms. This is truly a mystery, since both the sperm and the egg cells carry their own mitochondria at the moment of fertilization. So how do the paternal mitochondria disappear? The two leading theories claim that paternal mitochondria are either passively diluted by the vast maternal mitochondrial pool or actively eliminated by the egg. To solve this mystery, researchers from the Weizmann Institute of Science studied Drosophila flies and examined the fertilization process up close. The Drosophila sperm cell is several millimeters long, placing it among the largest sperms in nature. Its mitochondria are not scattered, but fused into an elongated structure known as the mitochondrial derivative. This structure is tightly linked to the axoneme, the core apparatus that propels the sperm, ensuring its mobility. Their egg cells are also notably large, measuring about half a millimeter, making this species an ideal model for studying how paternal mitochondria disappear during fertilization. As we follow the mitochondrial derivative under the microscope, we see a process that is far from passive. It is an active and deliberate degradation, a targeted elimination of the paternal mitochondria within the fertilized egg. These observations raise a fascinating question in cellular biology. How can an egg cell actively break down something as large and substantial as the sperm's mitochondrial derivative? As they further explored this process, the researchers discovered an extraordinary phenomenon. New evidence showed that upon entering the egg, the sperm is immediately met with a swarm of multivesicular bodies. They converge on the sperm tail, and something extraordinary happens. They start to fuse, forming what appears to be a continuous vesicular sheath around the entire length of the sperm tail. This is not an indiscriminate aggregation. It's a selective and purposeful assembly, hinting at a highly specialized mechanism at work. The mitochondrial derivative, once encased within this newly formed vesicular sheath, breaks apart into smaller chunks. When the researchers explored the nature of this structure, they found a surprising clue to its way of function.
We observed that the vesicular sheath is covered with a protein that is called Rubicon. And this was very surprising because Rubicon is mostly known for its role in innate immune responses against invading microbes. This cell led us to explore the complete pathway, which we now know that is very similar to a known pathway called LC3-associated phagocytosis, which the egg repurposes here to destroy the paternal mitochondria.
The purpose of this cascade is to bring the lysosomes to the paternal mitochondria so that the lysosomes can basically mediate the degradation of the paternal mitochondria. The lysosomes are cellular organelles that contain multiple enzymes that can break down essentially all the cellular structures. And by bringing the lysosome, they can basically come and degrade the paternal mitochondria. The surprising discovery is that the egg utilizes such an aggressive mechanism in order to target the paternal mitochondria, which basically suggests that the egg perceives the paternal mitochondria as a dangerous trespasser.
That's how the egg ensures that only maternal mitochondria remain. For more information, read the full paper on Nature Communications.